Ladies and gentlemen, please give a very warm Crufts welcome to the finalists in the pastoral group. Ladies and gentlemen, we're starting with the Anatolian Shepherd Dog. The Australian Cattle Dog. The Australian Shepherd. The Bearded Collie. The Belgian Shepherd Dog, Groenendaal. The Belgian Shepherd Dog, Lacanois. The Belgian Shepherd Dog, Malinois. The Belgian Shepherd Dog, Tervuren. The Border Collie. The Briard. The Rough Collie. The Smooth Collie. The Estrella Mountain Dog. The Finnish Laphund. The German Shepherd Dog. The Hungarian Kuvas. The Hungarian Puli. The Commodore. The Lancashire Heeler. The Maremma Sheepdog. The Norwegian Boohund. The Old English Sheepdog. The Polish Lowland Sheepdog. The Pyrenean Mountain Dog. The Pyrenean Sheepdog. The Samoyed. The Shetland Sheepdog. The Swedish Valhund. The Cardigan Corgi. And last but by no means least, the Pembroke Corgi. Ladies and gentlemen, I now hand you back to Graham Hill in the commentary box.
Thank you, Chris. Well, looking around the perimeter of our arena, you can see this is quite a large group. There are 30 pastoral breeds represented here. And these are the finalists of an entry of 3,605 breeds representing the pastoral group here at Crufts 2008. This is a group made up of breeds related to the farming of sheep or cattle and are in the main used for herding and or protecting flocks of sheep or herds of cattle. Herding dogs have been used since the very early days of man's close association with dogs. Not only have they been used to herd sheep and cattle and other animals, dogs were also used to guard their flocks from predators. Andrew's initial look over each of the breeds present, and the first of the breed to be examined is the Anatolian Shepherd Dog. The breed was judged today by Mrs. Brenda Banbury, and there was an entry of 21 from which she selected this bitch, exhibit number 14008. Correction there, this one is a male. Siberian shepherd dog from his natural homeland is Turkey, is prized for his faithful devotion to his role as a flock guard. He's a tall dog and of massive type, and presents an awesome sight to marauders, whether they be wolves or men who threaten his flock. This is our best of breed Anatolian shepherd dog, exhibit number 14008. Move swiftly on to the Australian cattle dog. Mr. S. Hall was the breed judge, who has an entry of 54, and this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 14053. Decades of crossbreeding. Ancestral stock involved included the dingo, the blue merle smooth collie, the Dalmatian, and possibly the bull terrier. The breed greatly prized in his native Australia for his working ability. That's the best of breed Australian cattle dog, 14053. And now we see the Australian shepherd. Mr. Jeff Luskett was the breed judge, who has an entry of 141, and he selected this bitch as best of breed, exhibit number 14168. Surprisingly enough, the Australian Shepherd does not originate in Australia. The breed is a product of the United States of America. Go back to the Basque Spanish sheepdog. It was a breed built on powerful lines. It was versatile, and as you can see, a handsome dog. Our best of breed Australian Shepherd, exhibit number 14168. And now we see the best of breed bearded collie. There was a large entry of 375, and the breed had two judges. One for males, Mrs. S. Nichols Ward, and for bitches, Mrs. M. Appleby. And they selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 25023. This is a breed that has a long association with Scotland and Northern England, where he was bred for herding sheep. The breed is affectionately known as a hardy dog with a lovable temperament. It is ideally suited for country life. He has a double weather-resistant coat and a very active nature. That's the best of breed bearded collie, exhibit number 25023. And here we see the first of our Belgian shepherd dog varieties, the Groenendael. This is V.A. Thompson's the breed judge. There was an entry of 84, and this male was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 14551. As I said, the Belgian Shepherd dog comes in four varieties, and this is the first of those varieties. The Belgian Shepherd dog dates back to the Middle Ages. It began to separate into four varieties around 1891. The Groenendael is fundamentally long-haired and with a black, harsh, textured coat. That's the best of breed Belgian Shepherd dog Groenendael, 14551. And now we have the Belgian Shepherd dog Black and Noir. Mrs. Jenny Biddleton was the breed judge. And from her entry, she selected this bitch as best of breed, exhibit number 14571. This variety was a favourite of Queen Mary Henriette, whose royal residence, the Chateau de Lacalle, in Boom, near Antwerp, Please rise to the right and then back and right. This is the rarest of the Belgian Shepherd Dog varieties in the United Kingdom. The breed has a short, wiry type coat, which is reddish fawn, as you can see here. That's the best of breed Belgian Shepherd Dog Black and Noir 14571. On the next of the Belgian Shepherd Dog varieties is the Malinois. Again, this variety was judged by Miss J. Biddlecombe. And from an entry of 41, she selected this bitch as best of breed, exhibit number 14600. The Malinois became the gauge by which other Belgian Shepherd Dogs were judged. The Malinois takes its name from the Malinois area in the country of origin, Belgium. This variety also has its own individual coat type. Shortish, firm textured coat, which may be red, fawn or grey, with black overlay. That's the Belgian Shepherd Dog Malinois Best of Breed, 14600. And here we see the Belgian Shepherd Dog Turbarum. Mr. T.R. Calgrove, the breed judge, and from an entry of 136, he selected this bitch as Best of Breed, 14684. This is the most popular and is the variety most rapidly increasing in numbers within the United Kingdom. All the varieties are described as having fine proportions and proud carriage of the head, conveying an impression of graceful strength. This description, I think, really does apply to the Turbarum. And here we see the best of breed, Belgian Shepherd Dog Turbarum, exhibit number 14684. And now we see one of the breeds that has the largest entry here today, for 479 Border Collies. Dogs were judged by Mrs. S. Hughes and bitches by Mrs. A. L. M. Gillespie. This male was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 14737. This is a breed that has a highly intelligent bearing and was inborn instinctive work and was originally used for working sheep in the hills and mountains, mainly in the border countries of England, Scotland and Wales. Still the most popular working sheep dog in Great Britain and Ireland. The Border Collie can make an affectionate but difficult pet, especially in the city. That's our best of breed Border Collie, 14737. And then we have the Briard. Mr. Max Jones was the breed judge and with an entry of 82. And this male was selected best of breed, exhibit number 15141. The Briard's ancient origins are unknown. It was once classified as the goat-haired variety of the Beauceron. It has been suggested that it was developed by crossing that breed with the Bourbette. Has also been called the Berger de Brie. Brie has a dry, goat-like coat with its moustache, beard and eyebrows requiring regular and thorough grooming. One of the breed characteristics is it has dew claws on its back legs. That's the best of breed Briard, exhibit number 15141. Now we have the best of breed Rough Collie. Mrs. V. Geddes, Judge Males, and Mrs. J. Wigglesworth, Bitches. There was an overall breed entry of 330. And this male was selected best of breed, exhibit number 15236. This breed originated in its present form in the cold regions of northern Scotland. The working rough collie was possibly the shorter in leg, especially in today's elegant breed. Thought to have evolved around the 1800s from dogs brought originally into Scotland by the Romans. That's the best of breed rough collie, 15236. And now we see the smooth-coated variety, the smooth collie. Mrs. I. Cozens was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 67, from which she selected this bitch, exhibit number 15512. Same as the rough collie, with the exception of coat length. As you can see here, the smooth has a short and flat coat with harsh texture on a dense undercoat. That's our best of breed, smooth collie, 15512. And here we have the Estrella Mountain Dog. Mr. P. Albergari was the breed judge. There was an entry of 41, and he selected this male, exhibit number 15573, as best of breed. This most popular of all the Portuguese breeds is one of the oldest on the Iberian Peninsula. Descended from the ancient Asiatic Mastiffs, brought to the West, and is related to the Spanish Mastiff. This one, incidentally, is of the smooth-coated variety. That's our best of breed, Estrella Mountain Dog, 15573. And we move on now to the Finnish Lapland. There were 80 breed entries today, and Mrs. J. Vaughan selected this male as best of breed, 15606. As the name implies, this breed originates in Finland. The breed is spitz type, and his thick jacket comes in all manner of colours. And this enables him to cope with the harsh climate of Lapland. This is the Finnish Lapland, exhibit number 15606. And next we see the German Shepherd Dog. Mr. T. Hannon was the breed judge. There was an entry of 146, and this male was judged to be best of breed, exhibit number 15674. The German Shepherd Dog is arguably the most popular breed, not only in the United Kingdom, but in the world. This breed has been used as herding dogs and developed as a police and military dog. He is highly intelligent, creative, and needs to be occupied. That's the best of breed German Shepherd Dog, exhibit number 15674. And now we move on to the Hungarian Kuvash. This was another breed judged today by Mr. Jeff Luskett. And he selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 13612. The Kuvas is an independent, powerful dog used for the protection of flocks of livestock in Hungary by a nomadic herdsman. The breed has also been adapted to become a guard dog for people and property. Some authorities believe this great white guard dog arrived in Hungary in the 1100s with the Cuman nomadic Turkish tribes. It was first mentioned as a breed in the late 1600s. That's the Hungarian Kuvas best breed, exhibit number 13612. And here we have the Hungarian Puli. This is Jay Farmfield, who's the breed judge. There's a breed entry of 57. And this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 15783. There really is no mistaking the Hungarian Puli, although the casual observer may be confused as to which way the dog is heading. The most notable feature of the breed is the corded coat. Friendly disposition and consequently is highly companionable. However, he does command a fair share of exercise. That's the best of breed Hungarian Puli, exhibit number 15783. And now we see the common dog. This was another breed judged today by Mrs. Brenda Banbury. And from her entry, she selected this bitch as best of breed, exhibit number 15827. The common dog is another breed which hails from Hungary and is used as a guardian dog for herds and flocks of sheep on farms. But it was not until around 1910 that the common dog was firmly established as a modern breed. The breed has an easygoing attitude, especially to exercise. This is the best of breed common dog, exhibit number 15827. Now we see one of the smaller of the breeds in this group, the Lancashire Heeler. Another breed judged today by Mr. Jeff Luskett. There was a breed entry of 100. And this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 15879. This is an intelligent breed, eager to please, and has a love of people. The breed is found in the Lancashire area and was bred there as long ago as the 1600s. It did, however, become extinct in the late 1800s, but being regenerated from the 1960s. This is a breed that enjoys the company of children. That's because he likes to join in their games. That's the best of the Lancashire Heeler, 15879. Now we move on where we see the Morella Sheepdog. Lady Walsh was the breed judge. There was an entry of 11. And she gave best of breed to this mare, exhibit number 15921. This is a breed that's still used in Italy to guard the shepherd flocks. It was name comes from the Morena Plains, where he was used extensively for shepherd duties. This breed first appeared in Britain around 1872, but was still relatively rare until 1976, when efforts were made to import a breed of good stock. That's the Morena Sheepdog, exhibit number 15921. And here we have the Norwegian Bullhund. This is Jay Purvis, who's the breed judge. There's a breed entry of 53, and this male was selected as best of breed, 15948. Once the Norwegian Bullhund was used to pull sleds and as a hunter companion. It now serves as a herder, a guard dog, and a companion. The breed is used as an alert guard and an efficient herder in his native Norway, and the Bullhund is one of the earliest known Nordic herding dogs. Boo in Norwegian apparently means homestead, so the Bullhund is the dog found on the homestead or farm. That's the best of breed Norwegian Bullhund, exhibit number 15948. And here we see the best of breed Old English Sheepdog. There were 181 exhibits here today. And from that entry, this is S.M. Swatkins, selected as male as best of breed, exhibit number 16109. This breed is regarded as a native to British waters and is often affectionately known as the bobtail. This profuse coat is a distinctive feature of the breed, and it is weather resistant, but does need plenty of time and patience for grooming by its owner. This is the best of breed Old English Sheepdog, 16109. And now we have the Polish Lowland Sheepdog. This is E. Georgian, was the breed judge. There was a breed entry of 64 made by 57 exhibits. And this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 16160. As the breed name implies, the breed's country of origin is Poland, where he is affectionately known as Puss. This is a breed said to originally come to Britain in the 16th century, when the sailors from Gdansk exchanged their dogs for other animals at the Scottish ports of call. A breed with a long history. Apparently has been used as for herding since the 1500s. This is the best of breed Polish Lowland Sheepdog, 16160. See the Pyrenean Mountain Dog. Mr. J. Kirk was the breed judge. There was an entry of 145. And this male was made best of breed, exhibit number 16261. One of the great white guarding mastiffs that spread across Europe. This magnificent breed is probably related to the Italian Morena, the Hungarian Kuvac and the Slovakian Kuvac, and Turkish Kalabosh. The breed thrived principally in Angora, in the Pyrenees, for it was discovered early in the 20th century. As the name implies, the breed's home is the Pyrenees mountain range in France. That's the best of breed Pyrenean mountain dog, 16261. And now we see the Pyrenean sheepdog. This one is a male, exhibit number 16325, and was selected by Mr. F.J. Randall from an entry of 18 for best of breed. Again, as the name implies, this breed originated in France in the area of the Pyrenees. Small energetic sheepdog which has been selectively bred to herd large flocks of sheep in rural areas. With its strong herding instinct, this highly intelligent breed has tremendous energy and stamina for its size. That's the best of breed Pyrenean sheepdog, 16325. And then we see the Samoyed. Mr. J. Bispham was the breed judge. There was an entry of 183. And this bitch was selected best of breed, exhibit number 16343. This breed is truly the canine equivalent of the Laughing Cavalier. As the breed standard requires, he has a smiling expression. Known affectionately as the Sammy, he is good-natured, alert, intelligent, and full of action. That's our best of breed Samoyed, exhibit number 16343. And now on the table we have the Shetland Sheepdog. There was a large entry of 365, and so we had two judges. Dogs were judged by Mr. M. Hart, and bitches by Mrs. D. Moore. They jointly selected this bitch's best of breed, exhibit number 16683. A breed originating from the Shetland Islands in the northeast of Scotland. To a number of animals which are small in stature, but none as elegant and as beautiful as this breed. Sometimes called the Sheltie, this is an affectionate, intelligent, and particularly active breed. That's the best of breed Shetland Sheepdog, 16683. And now we have the Swedish Valhund. Mrs. D. Edmonds was the breed judge. There was an entry of 54, made by 54 exhibits. And this one is a male, exhibit number 16852. The Valhund is also called the Swedish cattle dog, identifying both his country of origin and his purpose. Guard from the point of view of giving warning to approaching strangers, but he tends to have a friendly, cheerful disposition and is always ready for exercise. The breed nearly disappeared in the 1930s, but mainly due to the efforts of Count Bjorn von Rosen, was saved and was recognized by the Swedish Kennel Club in 1948, and recognized in Britain by in 1984 by R. Kennel Club. That's the best of breed Swedish Valhund, 16852. see the first of our two Welsh Corgi varieties, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi. Mr. S.J. Parsons was the breed judge. There was an entry of 84. And this male was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 16928. Corgi was also known once as the yard dog because the length from the nose, tip of the nose to the end of the outstretched tail is measured for a Welsh yard. That's our best of breed Cardigan Welsh Corgi, 16928. Now we see the Pembroke Welsh Corgi. Mr. Albert White was the breed judge, then an entry of 194. And this bitch was selected as best of breed, exhibit number 17052. As you may know, this is a favourite breed of our Queen. His pricky ears and his lovely features give him an appearance of being interested in everything that's happening around him. Corgi is a thoroughly practical breed. You can live with all sorts of households, from paupers to royalty. That's our best of breed, Pembroke Welsh Corgi, 17052. In the classical group having been examined. This is Zena Thorne Andrews. Walks along the line just to have another look at each of the breeds before selecting her shortlist. As I said earlier, there are 30 breeds on show here. Finalists of some are over 3,000 entries in the working group here at Crufts 2008. Right, as Mrs. Zena Thorne Andrews goes back to the start of the line, out coming the Australian Shepherd. The Belgian Shop, the Shepherd Dog, Lac & Noir. The Briard, the Rough Collie, the German Shepherd Dog. Mountain Dog, the Samoyed, and the Cardigan Welsh Corgi. That concludes our shortlist, and again, can I ask you to congratulate our other shortlisted breeds, or other breeds in the pastoral group, on their success here at Crufts 2008. As in other groups, and our shortlisted breed will be moved again. Just to wait for our other breeds to leave the ring. And first to be moved is the Australian Shepherd, 14168. And the Belgian Shepherd dog, Black and Noir, 14571. And now the Briard, 15141. The Rough Collie, 15236. And off goes the German Shepherd dog, 15674. And here we see the Samoyed, 16343. And the eighth of our shortlist of breeds to move is the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, 16928. So, each has been examined, each moved again. So we're nearing a decision for the fifth of our breeds to compete for Best in Show on Sunday. The winner of this, the Pastoral Group. So the winner of the Pastoral Group Quest 2006 is the Samoyed, 16343. And Group 2 is the Australian Shepherd, 14168. Group 3, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, 16928. And Group 4, the Pyrenean Mountain Dog, 16261. So again, can I ask you to congratulate the other four shortlisted breeds as they leave the ring, having shaken the hand of our judge. And as our judge returns to her winners, will I introduce the person who will present the trophies for us here tonight. It's Dr. Frances Barr, president of the BSAVA, and she's escorted into the ring by Eric Smethurst, the Crufts chairman. So just to recap, the winner of the Pastoral Group Crufts 2008 is the Samoyed, exhibit number 16343. Pastoral group two is the Australian Shepherd, 14168. And pastoral group three, the Cardigan Welsh Corgi, 16928. And group four, the Pyrenean Mountain Dog, 16261. And as our winners do their lap of honour, can I ask you again to show your congratulations? A warm applause to our winner of the Pastoral Group Crufts 2008, the Samoyed, 16343.